today we're talking about using this NVIDIA RTX voice software. It's beta, it doesn't have a lot of features, but using it for actual video instead of using it for like streaming. I did it with my previous video on this channel. You can listen to that and see how it worked out. Not amazing, but still I think it did help quite a bit to remove unwanted noise. There are a lot of caveats to this. There's some issues. I have a GTX 1060 graphics card, so it's not a RTX graphics card. There is a current workaround with that, which we'll check out. But so here's the main page from NVIDIA. You can download it from there currently. Now, who knows if they'll remove it or change it, so it won't work on the older cards, but right now it does work. I'm going to look at the actual install process in my case, where it disallows people with older cards to use it. So here is the actual downloader, so around 350 megabytes or so. You can see that the installer does not allow you to install this beta software if you don't have an RTX card, but you can get around it with the forum posting here. Let me pull that up real quick. Guru3D forum. This person figured out that it installs to a temporary location, and you can adjust these constraints here to have it install on a different graphics card. Of course, you can check those forum postings out, they'll be in the description. But the path here is ctemp, and you've got nvrtx voice inside there, this nvafx folder, this rtx voice.nvi is what you want to look at. Inside temp, where it's this one right here, you want to copy that entire thing somewhere else, because inside temp it's a restricted folder, it's harder to edit things. I copied it over to a different area. So inside there, you would edit that text file, just delete this constraints thing, and it will install. There is another caveat that we'll get to. Here's the actual application. You can see it's very simple. You've got your input device and your output device. Now, I don't know if this will work for everyone. It's just in my case, I have an actual sound card, which allows me to do this specific one. It says what you hear. If you don't have that, this entire thing might not work for you, but you try things for yourself and see if you can get it working. If we go into here with this little icon for the RTX voice, that's gonna show up on startup. The main issue here is that it's not listed in the normal startup areas, so you can't disable it. And that's a big hassle, because if you have this thing running all the time, especially if you have it enabled, it's going to cause you issues with your audio. So if you want to remove that from the startup, someone on Reddit figured out how to disable that program. So it's just a web of goofy little things you have to deal with. So this guy here, sudo apt-get wrecked, he figured out that this application on Microsoft's website, so auto runs for Windows version 13.96, you download this, you get this, you want to run this. This is the one we want to uncheck. It says RTX voice. You just uncheck that and then it will not start up when the computer starts up. Here is the actual application. It's very simple. You can go into your sound properties and see that it took over the output and the input for Windows. It says RTX voice on both of those. And then you can select what actual inputs and outputs. So in my case, I have the what you hear thing, is which is what I'm going to use for this, to push some audio to it and then record it externally. That's basically the whole process, is that I've got this Zoom H1 recorder set to 48 kilohertz, 24 bit. And I've got the input going from the computer to the recorder. Here's generally what my audio looked like before doing any type of edits. You'll hear some of background noise. It's gonna play a clip. Just walking around, get some exercise. Actually forgot my microphone, so we'll see how this turns out with audio. To actually use the RTX voice software, if it's set up like this, check this box for the output. That way it's being applied to the output only. And just go into your editor. You can play it from there, but you might have some issues with if your editor drops some frames or something, the audio could get messed up. What I do is I extract the audio from my video editor. It's all clipped up, it's all ready to go. So in my case, I would do a render as and then select wave 48 kilohertz, 32-bit. I took it into Audacity to adjust the audio before pushing it into the RTX voice, which we can check out. Just walking around, get some exercise. Actually forgot my microphone, so we'll see how this turns out with audio. I do have a previous video on all of my audio process, which is pretty involved. And there's a basically compression, levels, and equalization to the audio. In this case, just make sure Audacity is set to the Microsoft sound source instead of any one of these other ones. That way it gets routed properly to the RTX voice. And then I would just play this from the beginning. this plays, you have to let it go all the way through, which is not ideal. I would prefer some type of software that I could quickly process it instead of having to do real-time audio playback. Another thing I should mention is that when I took the source audio from the Canon EOS M5, it has stereo two microphones. I split those up in Audacity and I just used one track, duplicated it, so that I wouldn't get weird stereo issues. Then this is the final thing that I got from the RTX Voice. We can play this. I'll mute the actual music. Today we're out with the Canon EOS M5. Just walking around, get some exercise. Actually forgot my microphone, so we'll see how this turns out with audio. Streaming or PC stuff. This is a complicated process. I don't know if it's a good thing to do, but it was interesting to see how that RTX voice works and see how well it does with outdoor audio. In my case, I had some clipping because of the wind, which was the main reason I tried it out. I don't think it did amazingly well with wind because you can't really recover the audio that's completely blown out. In some areas of the video, I do think it really did help quite a bit. So as I look at all this RTX voice beta software with a weird hacky solution of using it to push into full videos. So anyways, hope you enjoyed the video. Skeptography Banzai. Thanks.